Hello and welcome friends to Newtongate Academy. I hope you all are very well and doing good in studies. So today's subject is history. More or less everyone finds that history is a very boring subject, but no, not at all students. If you know history as a story, you will find it very much interesting. See, today only you will find that, history is really a very interesting subject. Now, today's topic is First World War. It is specially for class 10 students, but everyone can hear this. You will find it very much interesting. Now, the First World War, a Marxist analysis of great slaughter. Now, we will know about why this war happened, when this war happened, and what was the reason behind that war happening. Like every story, every incident, everything has a reason behind that. So this war has also one reason. Now, first thing is that when World War I happened, this is the main thing we should know first. Now, if you point like this, then you will find that it is very easy to write in the answer sheet. Always try to point out the basic points. Then you will find it very much easy. Now see, when was World War I happened? Now, World War I was a major war centered in Europe that began 4th August 1914 and lasted until November 11th, 1918. So this was the major time when this war happened. Now why like that? See, it involved all of the world's most powerful countries. Now see, only one and two countries didn't participate over here. Many powerful countries has participated in that World War I. Now there have been tension and competition between these powerful countries for many years. So it is very obvious, students, that if many countries are fighting together, then the situation is very much destructive. We all know that. Now, each country wanted to be the most powerful. So, you know that this is the basic thing of humanity, human being actually, that everyone wants to become more powerful. I don't know why, but yes, this happens. Now, this tension and competition eventually led to the First World War, and due to this, this was the main reason that everyone wants to become more powerful. So for that reason, this First World War happened. Now, in this section, we will get to know that which countries has participated in this World War. In this map only, we can see that which countries has participated. Now see, we can see Britain, Germany, Belgium, France, Italy, Russia. These all countries has participated in that World War I. Now, whenever you will write the question, you have to point it out very carefully that which countries had participated in World War I. This is the basic question which always comes. Now, why World War I happened? Now, we will get to know that what was the reason that World War I happened. Now, the war had many causes. So, there is not only one cause. There are many causes for happening this World War I. Now, the assassination of Archduke Franz Ferdinand was one of the main reasons. So, it all happened. For this person, basically, this War happened. Now, World War One was triggered on 28th June 1914 by the assassination of the Archduke Franz. Ferdinand of Austria and his pregnant wife, Sophie. So, he had a pregnant wife also whose name was Sophie. Archduke Franz Ferdinand of Austria was the nephew of Emperor Franz Joseph and heir to the throne of Austria and Hungary. So this was the relation, this was the main introduction of this person whose name is Archduke Franz Ferdinand. You should know this. Now, the assassination was planned by a Serbian terrorist group. And what happened after that? It caused the Black Hand, and the man who shot Franz Ferdinand and his wife was a Bosnian revolutionary named Gavrilo Princip. So these are all ideas and the planned structures happen in that scenario. Now, see, in the next part, we can see the pictorial image of that World War One. You can see it, student, that so much destructive even happened on that time. See how destructive it is. Now, in the next part, we can see that woman in World War One. See, women has also participated in this World War One. They have a big support when this World War One happened. They're given a big support. Now, basically after this, what happened? Now we can see it over here. Let's see. Here, in the centenary of First World War, the contribution made by American women are largely overlooked. When the reality is that women played a crucial and defining role in America's victory. Now, it is not only the man who has given his life, invested their life, but the woman also played a very big role of getting this victory. Now, thousands of men have been injured, but they had treated them, they had nursed them. Okay, so what happened in 1970 was a watershed year for America. Militarily and economically, America was cementing its position as a world power. So America is cementing. America is being getting his position in a much bigger way. Now, American industry was prospering in the run-up to the war. The American agriculture was shipping vast amounts of food to our allies in Europe. So these are the things which American women were doing. Like a big, tremendous thing, because food is also necessary for fighting. Without food, it is not possible for anyone to fight. So big thing, big contribution women were doing on that time. Now, in the next slide, we can get it that working women during World War One. So, on that time, it was not very much easy for a woman to work, but many women was there who was very much courageous, very much entertaining, and very much brave, intelligent. For that reason, they thought and they decided that they will not sit back home. They will definitely do a work just like as a man. See how courageous they were. We should salute them. Now, at the next part, we can see that end of World War. Now, children, every story has a beginning and a ending also, and the war has also like this only. Now, what was the ending point of World War? Now, we can see over here that World War I, it started in 1914 and ended in 1918. At last, it finally over. Like, it took more or less than 4 years. It's a huge time. And many damage happened for that reason. 4 years means, you know, children, that how destructive it was. So this happened. And what was the reason behind that? See, Germany had formally surrendered on November 11, 1918, and all nations had agreed to stop fighting while the terms of peace were negotiated. Now, why this happened? Germany had already surrendered, and they said that yes, we all need peace. Many destruction happened, many damage happened, and just because of the cause of peace, everyone said that yes, we will end this war now because we all need a peace. Now see that this was the pictures of after ending World War I. So many people were so happy that finally World War I ended. See the peaceful moment of them. Now, at the last part, effects after World War I. So, everything has an effect. Okay, so see what happened. Before World War I, feeling of optimism and progress of humankind, they started thinking about that, yes, now we should try to become more good human being because many destruction has happened. Now, after the war, feelings of pessimism, new forms of art, literature, philosophy and science, this all thing have introduced in a new form, in a new manner. And that's a very good and valid point. You must note down that what had happened at the end of the war. Now, children, I think you have, in from this class, you have get a little summary of World War I. And I'm very much sure that you have find it very much interesting. So I hope you like this video a lot. So if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe. And we will meet like this as a short summary of history of any other chapter. We will meet in our next video. So thank you guys.